From the Lloyd Noble Center in Norman, it's the opening round of the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship and a play-in meet between the Ball State Cardinals and the North Carolina State Wolfpack, with the winner moving on to the second session of tomorrow's second round of this Norman Regional. Alongside the former Oklahoma Sooner National Champion Natalie Brown, I'm Chad McKee. For Ball State, it is the second regional in program history. For NC State, it's the 32nd in program history and the second in the last 3 years. Natalie, as you size this one up, what do you see between these two teams?
I think that it is going to be such a great matchup. You know, both teams finished second in their conference competitions. Their NQS is separated by less than 0.2. You know, it really is going to come down to the small details, like stuck landings and hitting your handstands.
And in fact, when you talk to Kim Landris, the North Carolina State head coach, she said that's what it came down to in the conference meet. They lost by 0.3, which is, as you said, less than a tenth. That's just how close it was for them in winning potentially the EAGL championship, which was won by Towson. Ball State also the runner-up, as you said. That was in the MAC, as they finished up there in Kent, Ohio, out of seven teams in the MAC. We are just about set to go. It'll be North Carolina State beginning on vault, and Ball State will begin on the bars as we go gymnast for gymnast here. Once again, the winner of this advances to tomorrow. They will not have the top seed Oklahoma in that evening session. Alabama will kind of be the lead dog in that session of round number two tomorrow. So set to begin. And for North Carolina State, it'll be Gabrielle Diaz first on vault.
Opens up with the Erchenko full, just a slight hop on the landing. I saw a little bit of form deduction in the air, so that will be a deduction, but a good start for North Carolina.
Kim Landers said she just kind of does her thing as the leadoff in three different events. Gabrielle Diaz, we work over to Leah White first up on the uneven bars for Ball State.
Opens up with a Maloney straight into a pack salto to the low bar. Just a little leg separation. Misses that last handstand. Doesn't quite get the stick on the landing, but a good start for them as well.
So we'll get the score there. Krista Zoltevich will be next up on vault, senior from Schickskinny, Pennsylvania. Very fun, positive energy type of competitor. Been a great addition to the team, said Coach Kim Landris. And she is set to go second. Waiting for scores to post from the previous vault from Gabrielle Diaz.
Another Yurchenko full. Better block off the table. Holds on to that landing. Just a small hop backwards, but keeping it steady over there for NC State.
So we got Gabrielle Diaz's score. It was a 9-7 in the leadoff position for the Wolfpack. And we'll get Zoltevich's score in just a moment. Back over to Megan Teeter next up for Ball State on the uneven bars. Teeter senior from Copley, Ohio, Gym World. She was participant in the 2021 NCAA Regional, also on bars, and she's an NCAA individual qualifier. Even if Ball State doesn't make it through today, she will be in the individual competition of this regional. Joanna Salim said, this is our bar setter. She's added events every year. Said all the pieces have been there. But the team environment has really brought it out for this competitor. And she set the program record on bars earlier this year with a 9.925. See if we get the score for Grace Sumner, who was first up. It was a 9.75. So there was a little change there. And I think there has been a change in the lineup here for Ball State. We have not been made aware of it. So we apologize for that.
She opens up her routine with a Maloney to a Bale. Really nicely done. Almost gets that last handstand, heading into her dismount now. Blind full into a double back. Gets that stick, though. That's one out of six so far for Ball State.
So the opening score for Grace Sumner was a 9-7-5. Waiting to see the score for Krista Zultevich on the vault. And scheduled next will be Alexis Ortega.
Great block off the table. Goes for the stick, but has to take a hop. That was probably the best vault that I've seen so far in this competition. You'll notice that they're doing Yurchenko fulls. Those vaults will start from a 9.95. They will not start from a 10.0. That is going to be the biggest difference, I would say, between both of these teams. When Ball State moves to vault, you'll see a lot of unique vaults and some that will start from a 10.0.
So Krista Zultevich's score was a 9.65. Just a moment ago on the vault. Back over to the uneven bars. Grace Evans is next up. We've seen Grace Sumner and Zoe Middleton to this point. Grace Sumner scored 9.75. We don't yet have the score for Zoe Middleton. But Grace Evans ready to go. Senior from Dallas, Georgia, Gymnastics Academy of Atlanta, fourth year in the program. She was also on the 2021 regional team that went to the Tuscaloosa regional.
Starts off with a pike digger straight into a shoot over. Has some trouble gripping the bar there. It's an unfortunate fall for them this early in the competition. Just her dismount now. Double back. A little hop out of that landing. Uncharacteristic of her, but, you know, she went back up there, finished the routine. Definitely not what she wanted to do, but it happens.
Zoe Middleton had a 9.8, so the two scores, Sumner a 9.75, Middleton a 9.80, and Lauren Rutherford is next up on vault.
Great Yurchenko full. She found that landing and got the stick. What a great vault from her.
So perhaps the best we've seen so far on vault.
For sure.
For North Carolina State, coming from the sophomore from Roswell, Georgia, Lauren Rutherford. And back over to Victoria Henry now for North Carolina State on the uneven bars. Still waiting for the score of Grace Evans. They go back and forth in true rotation style, which is great for the onlookers inside the Lloyd Noble Center and everybody watching at home. But all eyes are on you, Natalie. You know that it's the spotlight for you. Nobody's paying attention to anything else.
Nope, and you know the pressure that comes with this meet as well. You know, one person will come out of this and get to compete tomorrow, and the other will have to go home. Starts off her routine with a Maloney straight into a pack salto. Just a little bit soft in those knees. Into her routine with a front double tuck almost gets the stick, but has to take a small hop. But that was a pretty solid routine.
So Victoria Henry fourth up in the rotation on bars. Middleton has a 9-8. Sumner 9-7-5. Grace Evans had a 9-1-5 with the fall. So just to stick and not have another fall, super important, obviously, for Ball State. We get back to North Carolina State.
Great block off the table and great distance as well. And she stuck the landing there, too. That was a great vault NC State.
Emily Shepard there. We'll get the score on it. So far, it's a 9-7-7-5 for Rutherford, 9-7 for Diaz. Zoltevich a 9-6-5, and the same for Ortega. And we will see if Emily Shepard betters that one.
I think she should at least get a 9-8 or better on that vault.
Emily Shepard, one of the real anchors in the lineup. And for North Carolina State, Hannah Ruthberg will be up next on the uneven bars. Or I should say for Ball State on the uneven bars. Ruthberg Jr. from Wauksat, North Carolina. She's an NCAA individual qualifier in the all-around, kind of the cheerleader on this team, very vocal. She did the all-around at the conference meet, and we'll see her as the leadoff on the floor exercise. Joanna Salim told us that she is full send on everything.
Opens up with a Ray and has an unfortunate fall right there. It looked like it hurt, so I hope she's okay. You hate to see that happen.
And you see getting ready is Chloe Negrete on the vault. And now how difficult is this, what Hannah Ruthberg will have to do?
And it's also difficult having a fall already earlier in the lineup and then knowing that now one of those routines will count. So every 10th does matter when you get back up on the bar because you want to take the best routine that you can.
The Cardinals did get a 9-8-2-5. From Victoria Henry just a moment ago, but now Ruthberg has to remount and finish the routine.
Looks like she's redoing the skill to get the bonus back. Missing those handstands and just slight form in those knees. But she got through the routine, went back up there, so she should be proud of herself.
So she is able to finish it off. Megan Teeter will be the final competitor on the uneven bars for Ball State. And patiently waiting to go down the runway, Chloe Negrete. Solid score so far for the Wolfpack, headlined by Emily Shepard's 9-8-5 on vault.
Great block off the table, flares it a little bit before the landing, but has to take a hop forward that might be deducted for under rotation. But that was a solid rotation for NC State over there on the vault. I know that they were hoping to get more landings, but it was a good start for them.
Yeah, North Carolina State vault, you just want to get off to a solid beginning. And Kim Landris said, we want entry, want explode off the floor, and more importantly, you want to stick everything, which they did through all six. Now, Megan Teeter ready to go for Ball State. Final competitor. They've had a couple of mishaps on the bars to this point, so critical, Natalie, here, that she try to stick this routine.
Yeah, you definitely want to end in this bar lineup with a good hit routine. Having two falls already in the lineup, just got to finish up strong and, you know, take it one routine at a time. Has to put it behind her.
Megan Teeter, senior from Copley, Ohio. Performed in that 21 regional event for Ball State that was at Tuscaloosa.
opens up with a blind full right into a straddle Takachev straight to the low bar. That shoot over. Nails that last handstand. Just the dismount now. Front double tuck, half. Just a slight hop, but that was a great way to end the lineup for bars for Ball State.
She was second on the bars at the MAC Tournament Championship. And so closing things out with what possibly will be the high score on the uneven bars on the opening rotation for Ball State. So rotation number one is in the books. We will total up the scores and get you set for rotation number two when we return to the Lloyd Noble Center. Welcome back to the Lloyd Noble Center and the 2023 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. This play-in meet, the winner moves on to the second session of round two here at the Lloyd Noble Center tomorrow night. And through one rotation, it's a lead of over 1 1/10 of a point for North Carolina State. And the Wolfpack ready to go on vault as they are set to take their turns. And in the leadoff spot on the vault will be Kaylee Adamitis. So you look at the grand scheme of things, Natalie, and both teams were well below their season averages on their first rotation, a couple of falls on the uneven bars for Ball State, and now they're down one full point. And I know that may not seem like that much, but a full point when we expect this to be a super close meet, it's going to be hard for Ball State to come back from it. They can't afford any more falls the rest of this afternoon.
Yeah, I know that that's not exactly how the team wanted to start off the meet, having two falls already on the bars. And then, honestly, vault was a good start for NC State, but I know that they were wishing to stick more landings. And, you know, anything can happen. There's still three more events to go for each of them, so this still might be a close meet.
So Ball State tied their best ever finish in the MAC championship with a second place finish back on March the 18th. They are still in the middle of the touch portion, and we are a couple of moments away from rotation number two. North Carolina State will be on the vault, and Ball State will move over to the uneven bars when we return to the Lloyd Noble Center. We welcome you back inside the Lloyd Noble Center in this play-in meet between North Carolina State and Ball State. After the adjusted scoring and the dropping of the lowest score for Ball State, they end up less than 3/10 of a point behind. It's actually down by 0.275 once they got everything totaled up and entered. So it is North Carolina State 48.650 and Ball State 48.375. So, Natalie Brown, I guess as you look at it, even with having to count a fall, Ball State's not in terrible shape. They are down by less than 0.3 of a point.
No, they're not out yet. And like I said earlier, they have a pretty dynamic vault lineup that we're about to see here, including two 10-0 start values, whereas North Carolina State had all 9.95 start values. So that might add into the total in their favor.
So you look out for Victoria Henry of Ball State, an individual qualifier in the vault, and then Suki Pfister, who was the first gymnast in program history to be a WCGA All-American. She was second team this year. Those are the dynamic vaults that you're talking about, or amongst them for Ball State, as the Cardinals can make up a little bit of ground here with Victoria Henry in the number six position as the anchor. Leah White set to go here in the leadoff position. Ball State trying to come back from down just a little under 0.3 of a point.
Leah will open up with a Yurchenko full, so starting from a 9.95. Excellent block off the table, lands a little bit over the line, and I saw some slight leg separation in the air, but that was a good set for Ball State to start on vault.
So Leah White there in the leadoff position. The high score so far on vault was a 9.875 from Chloe Negrete of North Carolina State. Now the Wolfpack set to go with their first routine on the uneven bars from Kaylee Adamitis. She's a freshman from Long Island, New York. And Kim Landris said she's just great in this leadoff spot, handles the attention great, and she provides depth on the floor exercise. And she's ready to go here on the uneven bars.
She's already looking so confident. Starting off her routine, she'll open with a Maloney up to the high bar, straight into a packed salto. It's very long, beautiful lines.
There's your stuck landing.
Yeah, it's with a stalder to a double back dismount. I might have seen just a slight hop, but I'm being picky. But that was a great leadoff routine for NC State to get started on bars.
The freshman from Walt Whitman High School in Long Island, New York, with an excellent beginning. And North Carolina State continues a very solid start. Back to Ball State, and Megan Teeter will be next up on the vault, senior from Copley, Ohio.
She is a powerhouse gymnast. She will do a unique vault here. She'll do a front handspring, front pike, and that will start from a 9.9 start value. And she stuck the landing. What a great vault from her.
Well, Leah White had a 9.625. Teeter is most definitely going to better that in the number two spot for Ball State. Peyton Childs will be up next for the Wolfpack on the uneven bars. Peyton Childs, a sophomore from Holly Springs, Texas, Holly Springs High School. That's Rob Starkle, who handles a lot of the uneven bars rotations for the Wolfpack.
I'm seeing lots of confident faces before each of their routines, which is great to see. You know, most importantly, they need to be having fun. Starts off with a switch grip right into a straddle Jaeger. Nails that handstand straight into a bail. Holds the landing a little bit, but has to take a hop forward. But that was a solid routine. Really hit those handstands. Just didn't get that stick on the end.
And that follows a 9.80 from Kaylee Adamitis in the leadoff position for North Carolina State on the uneven bars. Solid rope, a solid set for Peyton Childs there. Zoe Middleton will be up next on vault for Ball State.
And Megan Teeter received a 9.85, so that means she only had a half-tenth deduction off her vault.
Wow.
does a Yurchenko full, just a small step on that landing. You could tell she was happy with that. Traveled really far from the table, and that's exactly what the judges are looking for.
She has been excellent for this team. Freshman from Smyrna, Delaware, First State High School, and competing in three events as a freshman through the 13 meets so far this season. She had an Achilles injury as a junior in high school, so this is really her first season full go for Zoe Middleton. We'll see her score here in just a moment. Back to the uneven bars. Meredith Robinson up next for North Carolina State. Peyton Childs has a 9.75 and a 9.8 for Kaylee Adamitis so far for the Wolfpack. Meredith Robinson returned from injury on March the 12th against Texas Women's, Florida, and Washington. So happy to get her back in the rotation, three times all-conference on bars.
Starts off with a straddle Jaeger, beautifully done. Has such nice form in the air, floating down to the low bar on that pack salto. So far, this routine is gorgeous. Misses that last handstand. Almost gets the stick, just a small hop, but what a beautiful routine from her.
The bar specialist, happy to have her back, said Coach Kim Landris, because she is just wise. And she finishes up her set on the uneven bars. Taking a look at the scores so far on vault, Megan Teeter 9.8. Zoe Middleton 9.75 and Leah White a 9.625 for Ball State. Suki Pfister now.
Does such an well executed vault, a front handspring pie cap, just gets so high off that table, has such great block, and then turns so quickly around. Just had to take a slight hop backwards, but that vault is executed superbly.
She won the vault title in 7 of 12 meets this season for Ball State, and as we told you, she's already an individual qualifier in that rotation. She has at least a 9.8 on vault in all 12 meets so far to Suki Pfister. We will get her score in just a moment. Alexis Ortega set for her turn on the uneven bar, senior from Tampa Academy of Holy Names. Made her debut in the all-around on February the 10th. Hadn't done it before. Natalie, it's amazing that she's been able to do this as a senior, and then she wins the conference title in the all-around.
Yeah, no, that's incredible. Opens up with a Hindorf, very unique skill, into a bail to a toe hack. It's a little close on catching that bar there. Just a dismount now, beautiful double layout, small step backwards, but great flow throughout that entire routine, and a great routine.
So far a 9.825 for Robinson, a 9.8 from Adamitis, and Childs has a 9.75. We will get the score for Alexis Ortega in just a moment. Hannah Ruthberg now on vault.
Hannah will do a Yurchenko full, starting from a 9.95. Finds that landing and sinks it in there for a stick. Another great vault for Ball State. They're killing it over there.
Really good rotation for Ball State. Suki Pfister scored a 9.875 prior to Ruthberg. Teeter has a 9.8 as well. We get set for Emily Shepard on the uneven bars, waiting Alexis Ortega's score. It was a 9.85, so the high score so far for North Carolina State came from Alexis Ortega prior to this. Emily Shepard, the senior from Olathe South High School in Kansas, the most decorated gymnast in program history. The EAGL Gymnast of the Year two times over, including this year.
And she is so beautiful to watch. Just executes things so well. Opens up with that straddle Jaeger. Pack salto down to the low bar. Her toes are pointed, her knees are straight. It's everything that you want. Just her dismount now. Half in, half out. Doesn't quite get that landing. A great salute, quick from her. But that was a fabulous routine. Obviously, you want to get those sticks on the landing, but they're keeping the momentum going.
Emily Shepherd, an individual qualifier in the all-around in this NCAA Championship regional event. And now the final contestant will be Victoria Henry on vault. You see the scores so far, the high score being a 9.875 from Pfister.
Victoria will do a Yurchenko 1.5. Found the landing, gets the stick. Last week at the conference championships, or 2 weeks ago, she got the stick and got a 9.95 to secure the title. And that was another great vault from her.
And that 9.95 was a career high for her, in fact. Second time in Ball State history that they've won a conference vault title, coming from Victoria Henry. Was that a 9.95 again for her, do you think, Natalie?
I don't know. When I watched the video from 2 weeks ago, she held the landing just a little bit longer, so we'll see what the judges do with what she did right there, but that was a great vault.
Emily Shepherd just scored a 9.85 moments ago. Beg your pardon. Emily Shepherd was the last competitor. Still waiting to see her score as Lauren Rutherford gets set. 9.85 from Alexis Ortega, the high score so far on the uneven bars for the Wolfpack. Not anymore. You see a 9.9 for Emily Shepherd just posted.
And like I said, there was barely any deduction throughout that routine. It was just that small hop on that landing. She opens up with a Ray right here. Again, great form. Beautiful toe heck up to the high bar. Just the dismount. Double layout. Doesn't quite get the landing again right there. I think they're just getting a little bit too excited, but these are great routines that we're seeing.
She sold it, though.
She sold it. They look happy. They look like they're having fun. So you can just see right there, she got a little bit too excited, but her double layout was so beautiful. Was trying to finish quickly, you know. But it's just good to see the excitement with these gymnasts.
The sophomore from Roswell, Georgia, wrapping things up for North Carolina State on the uneven bars. We're halfway through this meet. We will total up the scores when we come back to the Lloyd Noble Center. Welcome back inside the Lloyd Noble Center in Norman and the 2023 NCAA Gymnastics Regional. By virtue of tying a season-high score of 49-225, North Carolina State has been able to widen its lead in this play-in event, and they lead by a little under a half a point, 0.435 over Ball State as we head to the third rotation. Natalie, you called for some stick landings, and both teams came up with those on those last rotations, but a career-high tying performance from both Alexis Ortega and Emily Shepherd on the uneven bars vaulted this North Carolina State team to an even larger lead.
Yeah, I think that that entire rotation for Ball State and NC State was great. I thought the energy was there. You know, in the first rotation, I thought everyone was a little bit slow and, you know, trying to adjust to this environment. You know, it's hard, but I really did think that they executed their routines a lot better, found some stuck landings, and now we're moving on to beam and floor, and I think that this rotation here is going to be great.
So you want to be peaking at the right time. It certainly looks like North Carolina State has done that here in this NCAA regional. What they have done is build themselves a lead, and now you've got Ball State trying to rally from behind, though not too far back, and extend their season for at least one more day. You see North Carolina State head coach Kim Landris right there, readying her team for this critical beam rotation. How do you feel? North Carolina State on beam, they've been solid all season long. Natalie, would you say?
Yeah, I think that they're very solid, and they have some unique skills here and there, have some triple flights. Alexis Ortega, she'll do a backhand spring Anoti, which is a series that you don't really see. And overall, I think they're a great beam team. It really just depends upon how they execute routine to routine. And then on floor, I think that that's Ball State's best event. So if they do what they normally do, they might have a great rotation.
Gabriel Diaz will lead things off on the balance beam. Diaz, Jennings, Zoltevich, and Ortega, the first four up.
Gabriel is a steady leadoff for them.
She's the leadoff in three different events.
Opens with a front aerial to a back handspring. Switch leap to split jump. I don't see any nerves from her so far. Goes into a cat leap to a switch half. Just really executing her routine, getting this team off to a great start on the balance beam. Now her dismount, back handspring, tuck one and a half, and she finds the landing for a stick. What a way to start off on the balance beam for NC State.
The junior from Tampa, Florida. What is it about some competitors as we look at this replay, Natalie?
You can just see her series right there. Again, the front aerial back handspring, beautifully done. And then that dismount again, finds the stick and sells it, and her team's excited.
I was going to say, what is it about some competitors? They're just built to be in that leadoff position. Nothing phases them.
They really are, and not everyone is made for that. Some people like being in the midst of the lineup, and some people like going first, and some people really love going last.
Anna Ruthberg goes out of bounds on that first pass on the floor exercise in the leadoff spot here for Ball State.
Not what Ball State wants to do right here, but she still has the rest of her routine, and the rest of the lineup has her back. Second pass, double pike. Just a little form in the legs, I would see. You'll see a lot of difficult tumbling from Ball State on the floor. Ends with a Rudy to a straddle jump. Finished her routine well. I know going out of bounds is not exactly what she was hoping for to start off this lineup, but it happens. Again, we're all human. But hopefully her team will continue the momentum, and you know, maybe we'll get to drop her score, because that will be a 10th off the final score.
And that's an atypical beginning for Hannah Ruthberg. She's been so solid for this team, also competing in the all-around today. Look at the all-around standings, and Hannah Ruthberg is down in fourth place. There are four competitors. We get back over to the balance beam. Macy Jennings here after a 9.825 from Gabrielle Diaz.
And she is a beam specialist, so this is her event. We'll start off with a triple flight series. Handspring layout. Nicely done and holds on right there. Great job from her. Switch leap to a tug three-quarter. Mm-hmm. All that's left now is her dismount. So far, this has been a great routine. Just a small step on that landing, but she's keeping the momentum going for her team there. You know, it's difficult heading to this event, but they're starting off strong. There's that triple flight series again right there. You can see she was a little bit off, but saved it. And then that dismount. Had a great sink on that landing, just had to take a small step forward.
So Hannah Ruthberg just took her turn on the floor exercise. Next up will be Taylor Waldo, senior from Stacy, Minnesota. She's a great story. Struggled her first season at Ball State and was wondering if she'd made the right choice, but she has continued. And the end of her first year, decided she was really going to be fully invested and has really gotten into it. A great success story for Joanna Salim and the Cardinals. Still waiting on Hannah Ruthberg's score. Ball State averages a 49-240 on the floor exercise. You see Ruthberg, Waldo, Middleton, Victoria Henry, then Pfister and Teeter. Just got another beam score in from Macy Jennings. Still don't have a floor exercise score. There it is. Hannah Ruthberg, a 9.625 prior to this from Taylor Waldo.
Taylor will open up with an E pass, a front double full. Done. Just a little bit sideways on that landing, but worked through it. Sometimes you can dance out of your passes to kind of cover things up here and there. You know, there's some pressure going after a team that might not have been the best. You know, you need to hit your routine. Does that back tuck. All of her passes are forward, so she needs that element. She'll enter routine with a Rudy. A very nice routine from her to get them back on track.
So Taylor Waldo there following the 9.625 from Hannah Ruthberg. And we have two scores in over on beam. We'll get to in a moment. Let's look again at Taylor Waldo.
There's that opening pass. You can see she landed kind of sideways, but danced out of it. And then that second pass, a front full to a front layout to a front tuck, triple combination. And then that back tuck right there.
Back to North Carolina State, a 9.825 from Diaz, a 9.80 from Macy Jennings. And the third competitor is Krista Zultevich.
Moving with great rhythm. That handspring layout, nicely done. Switch leap split. Not quite 180 on that switch leap. Cat leap to a side aerial, Sassone. Very cool combination from her. I love seeing all the different and unique combinations from each team. Just her dismount now, round off 1.5. Finds the landing, holds the stick. A great routine, you can tell she's so excited.
We saw Zultevich as part of the vault rotation as well.
Here's that series again, back handspring layout. Great unique combination. All smiles from her.
Back over to the floor exercise. Zoe Middleton now after a 9-8-0 from Taylor Waldo to get Ball State back on track.
Opens up with a front layout to a Rudy to a split jump. Just a little crazy on that landing right there. But again, as long as you work through it and dance your way out, sometimes you can cover it up. She'll end her routine with a double pike. Lands a little bit low there, but was able to work through it and come back into the lunge. But that was a solid routine. Again, the first pass landed a little bit crazy, but it was a solid routine.
Well, Zoe Middleton, the freshman from Smyrna, Delaware, we told you, competing in three events this year as a freshman. Not easy to do. Her first full season, you would say, removed from an Achilles injury back in high school. We just saw 9.85 on the beam from Ziltevich. Now Alexis Ortega.
Starts off with a leg up, full turn. Now we'll see her unique series. She does a back handspring to an Anoti. Very difficult. Normally she'll take a couple steps, but she was just a tad off right there, but was able to work through it. Switch leap split to a beat jump. Beautiful. So far she has great rhythm throughout this entire routine. Moving quickly and poised on the beam. Definitely something the judges are looking for. And does a switch leap to a piked gainer full dismount. Comes off the mat. That will be a deduction, but that was a solid routine. You could tell she was a little bit off on that, and it wasn't the best routine she could do, but overall, it was a good routine. Here's that series again. Just had a little bit too much power going into that Anoti and was a little off. And then here's that dismount, was already going a little crooked and has to step off the mat.
So we will get Alexis Ortega's score in just a moment. The best so far is Krista Ziltevich with a 9.85. And we get back over to the floor exercise for Victoria Henry.
Opens up with a front through to a double tuck. Has to take a step out of bounds. It's not what you want to see. We're just seeing some little mistakes from each team. You know, there's a lot on the line here.
Teammates really getting into it, you can see.
Enter a team with a double pike. A great way to finish up that routine. Lands it so well.
There is Victoria Henry Very strong all-arounder. Two-time second-team All-MAC. And she earlier this year broke the program record in the all-around with a 39.400. She has three of the top seven all-around scores in program history.
Here's that second pass again. Front layout to front, full. And then that last pass had a great ending to this routine. Just started off with that out-of-bounds step. So that will be a 10th off her final score.
Emily Shepard now on the balance beam for North Carolina State. Alexis Ortega just posted a 9.625. That is the low score so far. The high score is a 9.85 from Zoltevich.
Let me tell you, Emily Shepard on beam, she is stunning to watch. Just moves so elegantly. Again, like, her toes are always pointed. Her knees are straight. Beautiful switch leap to a straddle quarter. And not only does she have a great presence, she looks so confident too. That can't spring layout, super solid. I'm not seeing much from this routine so far that I would deduct, but. Just her dismount now, side aerial 1.5. Doesn't quite get that stick, but that was a beautiful routine. She moved so quickly throughout, just a slight hop on that landing. You can tell she's happy with that.
Already won individual event title on bars. That was a fine performance on the beam as well.
Yeah, and you can see in that series right there was super solid. And then that dismount, just got a little excited, hopped into that landing, but everyone's super happy for her.
So following a 9.70 from Victoria Henry, we see Suki Pfister up next on the floor exercise for the Cardinals.
She is a competitor on this event, really sinks into every single one of her landings and performs. Opens up with a double tuck. Solid landing. Front full to a front pike. You know, their head coach was talking about that some of their keys that they've been working on are their facial expressions and really interacting with the crowd and their teammates, and she really is doing that right here. Holds onto that landing right there on that double pike. I'm not sure if they'll give it to her. They might take a little bit for under rotation, but that was a great routine.
Suki Pfister was All Metro Athletic Conference on the floor exercise. She tied for third with a 9.925 at the conference meet.
First pass again, that double tuck. And then ends with that double pike. You can see, holds on, has to step out just a little quickly.
Quickly to Chloe Negrete on the balance beam.
Now, Chloe, she is very fierce. That's how I would describe her. When you watch her, her face is so controlled and confident on every single event that she competes. Very intense.
Has come back after missing all of 2022.
Great combination right there. I just love how quickly she finishes everything. Never seems to be off balance. her dismount now. Run up, double full. Can tell her teammates are so excited. She doesn't tend to smile that much, but that was a great routine. Again, that dismount right there. Just a small hop on that landing. Doesn't get the stick. Maybe she would have smiled if she would have stuck that, but she should be happy with that.
Megan Teeter is off and running already as the final competitor on the floor exercise for Ball State. High score so far, 9-8-5, that we just saw from Suki Pfister.
Opens up with a punch layout, Rudy. That might have been something new. I'm pretty sure the last competition she did a layout front full. Second pass, double back, just a little off on that landing, has to hop backwards. Stayed in bounds though. To a front layout to end this routine. And a good rotation.
So Megan Teeter wrapping things up on floor exercise. We'll get a look one more time.
Here's her second pass again, the back handspring double back. Just a little off on that landing. And then that last pass to end a great rotation.
She's an individual event qualifier already on bars and floor exercise for tomorrow at this NCAA championship event, trying to get Ball State there as a team as well. We total up the scores and head to the final rotation from the Lloyd Noble Center when we return. Welcome back to this opening round matchup in the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship, a play-in meet between the Ball State Cardinals and the North Carolina State Wolfpack. Winner moves on to the second session of tomorrow's second round of this Norman Regional at the Lloyd Noble Center. One rotation left, and the lead is 0.625, less than 1 point for North Carolina State. It is a good, solid lead for the Wolfpack, Natalie Brown, but it's not insurmountable. What would have to go wrong for North Carolina State and right for Ball State for the Cardinals to come back and potentially win this?
Great question. So Ball State, they need to be lights out on the beam to have a shot at winning this. And North Carolina State needs to have some uncharacteristic things, but they've been pretty steady moving since bars. They had a great bar rotation, and then they were above their season average on beams. So I don't expect that from them tonight, but we shall see.
Yeah, it was North Carolina State. A little bit of a slow beginning, though they did lead after the first rotation by about a quarter of a point, but then they matched their season high on the bars with a 49.225. We had the career high tying performances from both Alexis Ortega and Emily Shepard. Emily Shepard, in fact, wins the bars title, and that got them a little more sizable lead. The last rotation on beam, they were above their season average with a 49.175, and all of the rotations, or all of the routines that counted, were above a 9.8 for North Carolina State. Just solid. And they were led by Chloe Negrete in the anchor spot with a 9.875 to round things out. So on we go to the final rotation. And on the beam, Ball State will start trying to come from behind. There you see head coach Joanna Salim led Ball State to the 2023 MAC regular season title. They've had 9 of the 10 best scores in program history. And she was a volunteer assistant, in fact, at North Carolina State back in 1997-98. So she does have a tie to the opponent in this duel. She said, "We have a lot of unique skills, but you have to execute those unique skills to get the bonuses." And what they've really done, Natalie, is develop that depth. 7, 8, and 9 in the lineup, she said, over the last 3, 4, 5 years are now pushing for spots in the regular rotation. And that's been a big driver, as you could imagine.
Yeah, and that's important, too, not only to have backups, but it also pushes the people that are in the lineup to be at their best. If not, they might be replaced. So it's always great to have some depth.
And they have something called the Cardinal Gym Cup. It is where you get points for what you do in the gym, the weight room, the community. It's not just what you do in the gym. And at the end of the year, there's going to be a prize awarded. They haven't told the team what the prize is going to be, but the coaches know. So they will look forward to that at the end of the season, which they are hoping does not come today for most of their competitors. Ball State trying to come from behind against this North Carolina State team that has been solid all day. And up first, it'll be Victoria Henry on the balance beam.
Opens up with a switch leap to a straddle three-quarter. Backhand spring layout, just a little loose in those knees. Their coach was talking about how they just need to keep their consistency and dance through any mistakes they might have. You know, beam is all about keeping the rhythm, and if you're able to keep going and, you know, move fast, not hold on to anything, just keep it in the past, then you'll execute a good routine. A unique skill right there, and she nailed it. Just her dismount, backhand spring, 1.5, and she finds the landing. I think they'll give her that stick, and that was a great leadoff for Ball State, just what they needed. Here's that series again. Just a little off, and then just slight bend in those knees.
Been a good meet.
That dismount.
Sorry, Natalie, it's been a good meet for Victoria Henry. She was the individual event winner on vault, and she is second in the all-around behind North Carolina State's Emily Shepherd going into this final rotation. Over to the floor exercise, Gabrielle Diaz in the leadoff position for North Carolina State.
Gabrielle will open with a double pike. Beautifully done. Tell she's excited. You know, they just need to go out there and do what they're used to doing. Their coach was saying they need to have fun, you know, make Norman their home. You can tell right now in her facial expression, she's really enjoying her performance here. Second pass, front layout to a front full, holds for the stick on that. To end the routine. A great leadoff routine from her again. The third of the night. That's how you want to start the floor rotation.
You are right. And that was with a 9.825 leading off the beam rotation. Let's look again.
There's that double pike. And that second pass holds it for a stick right there. Has some fun in that dance, and then this last pass. Just a solid routine.
Quickly back over to the balance beam we go. And Grace Evans, 9.75 for Victoria Henry just a moment ago.
And we just saw her series looked like she nailed it perfectly, that backhand spring layout. Side aerial to a beat jump. She was a little off on that, so she stepped back and redid the skill. You can tell there's a little bit of nerves. That dismount, ground off 1.5. They are finding the landings. Wow. Another stuck dismount for Ball State on the beam.
So Grace Evans follows a 9.75 from Victoria Henry.
There's that dismount again, and you see she just finds that landing, gets the stick, and she's happy with that.
The senior out of Dallas, Georgia. We move back to the floor exercise for Alexis Ortega after the 9.75 from Victoria Henry.
Does a unique double leg up turn right there before her opening pass, which is a Rudy. One and a half to front layout, nicely done. You know, she hasn't had the best meet today, but this floor team so far is exactly how you want to end it. Front layout to a front full. A solid routine. I know she'll be happy with this. And another solid routine for NC State over there on the floor. There's that opening Rudy pass right there. That final pass.
Gabrielle Diaz had a 9.85. We move back over for Hannah Ruthberg on the balance beam. Victoria Henry has a 9.75, as does Grace Evans so far for the Cardinals.
She will do a triple flight series. Very unique right here. A handspring layout, back handspring. Super solid. Switch leap to a pike jump. Nicely done. You know, for what's on the line here, they don't seem very nervous anymore. They're just going through the motions now and hitting their routines like they know how. Didn't get that stick on the landing there, but that was a great routine. Obviously, the little things do add up, so hopefully the rest of the lineup can find those stuck landings. But there's that triple series again. Extremely difficult, and that dismount, just a hop on the landing, but a good routine.
The junior from Waxhaw, North Carolina, a real cheerleader on this team. Back to the floor exercise, and Krista Zultevich. Seen a 9.85 from Diaz and a 9.80 from Alexis Ortega so far.
So far, I'm loving their facials and their performance over there on the floor. Opens up with a very difficult 2.5 front tuck. With a double tuck, gets that landing, is so excited. Just dances to the end. But that was a solid routine. for Krista.
The junior from Schenectady, Pennsylvania. You see the fun, positive energy that Kim Landris has talked about with her, and we look one more time.
Here's that final pass again. Finds that landing. Just expressions for days. Here's that first pass. Just gets unbelievable height on that 2.5. And then that front tuck.
Back over to the balance beam. Grace Sumner next up. Hannah Ruthberg just had the high score so far for Ball State, a 9.775.
Does a unique combination right there, a side aerial to a back handspring. You could tell she was a little off, but she saved it. Goes right into a front aerial. You know, I've talked about it before, but I love the rhythm that this team has when they're on the beam. Just going from one skill to the other quickly. And her dismount now. Round off 1.5. Was a little under rotated. Has to take a step back. But that was a good routine. Can tell there. She just landed a little bit low. Has to take that step back. Just a little hiccups here and there throughout that routine.
She will be an individual qualifier on the beam on Thursday, even if Ball State does not advance as a team. And Grace Sumner led the Cardinals on beam at the MAC Championships with a 9.85. Back over to Lauren Rutherford on the floor exercise for North Carolina State.
She also opens up with a 2.5 front tuck. Oh, yeah. And didn't quite get out of the 2.5 the way she wanted and fell on the front tuck. You know, it's really difficult to continue a routine when you start like that. But you have to. And again, everything matters after that. You don't know what the person after you will do, so you have to keep going and do it for your team. With a double back, just a little short, taking that step forward. But finished the routine strong. You know, it probably wasn't what she was expecting, but mistakes happen. Can tell right there, just didn't get around on that 2.5 to find the perfect punch into that front tuck. And then ends with a double back, just a little bit short on that landing.
Wolfpack with a 9.80 from Ortega, 9.82 from Zultevich, and a 9.85 from Gabrielle Diaz. And we work our way back over to the balance beam and the grad student, Lauren Volpe.
Super steady side aerial to a beat jump. Does a back handspring layout. Very difficult, but made it look super easy. Leap combination right there. Again, with the pressure that they have on them, they are looking super steady on the beam. That's not easy. Goes into a gainer full dismount and gets the stick. Definitely what they need right now.
Mainly been a beam specialist throughout her career. Fifth year in the Ball State program for Volpe.
That triple series again. You can just see a slight bend in those knees, but wow, she landed that so well. And then that dismount here again finds the stuck landing.
You see Emily Shepard ready to go on the floor exercise. Lauren Rutherford had a 9.075, so the pressure's on now for Shepard and Negrete in the 5 and 6 spots on the floor exercise for North Carolina State.
Opens up with a double pike. Beautifully executed. She is just so fun to watch. Such a performer. Great execution. Front layout, front full, holds the landing. All that's left now is her final pass. Ends with a double back. So great. That was a fantastic routine from Emily Shepard.
Already with one individual event title tonight, Emily Shepard on the bars. That may get her close to winning a floor exercise title as well.
I think so, Chad. You can see right here, that front layout, front full. Landed so well. And then that final pass, right up back handspring, double back. Sells each landing. Great routine.
We get back over to Taylor Waldo, wrapping things up for Ball State for the day. Final competitor. Lauren Volpe had a 9.825 prior to this, the highest score so far on the beam for the Cardinals.
Does a unique series, a front aerial to a front handspring. Looking very steady. Nice switch leap to a straddle quarter. Front toss to a beat jump. You know, this meet is closer than you think. There is a fall on floor. Mm-hmm. The anchor will have to hit in order to secure this meet. But that was a great dismount. Almost gets the stick, just a slight step on that landing. But this is a close one. We'll see what happens. There's that dismount again. Front tuck 1.5. Just a slight step or heel movement on that landing, but another great routine for Ball State.
We will have to wait on all of the scores. Emily Shepard, though, just scored a 9.90 for North Carolina State with her floor exercise routine. You see the total so far. So if Negrete can have a clean performance here, they'll be able to drop Rutherford's 9.075 and likely seal this. And Chloe Negrete, she's been up there 3 times in the anchor position already. On the vault and on the beam, and now on the floor exercise. She's come through the previous 2 occasions.
Opens up with a double pike. Just steps out of bounds right there. You can see it'll be a 10th off the final score. Just a little bit too much power. You know, it's difficult going into new arenas and new places, having to learn the equipment in such a short period of time. And I think these athletes are handling it so well.
She was first team all EAGL on the floor exercise.
Front full to a front layout. Excellent. the execution that she has in her leaps is wonderful. She goes above 180, which is what you want to see. Now just for her last pass, ends with a double tuck. Great landing. That should do it for NC State.
Chloe Negrete comes through one more time. She had a 9.875 as the anchor on the beam and a 9.875 as the anchor on vault.
You can see right there on that first pass, she took a step out of bounds. I don't think that that will hurt the score too much in order for NC State to come above Ball State, but we shall see.
You could almost make Chloe Negrete the MVP of this. She has won the beam title individually now that all of the scores are in. And you see that North Carolina State by 0.125 winning once all of the scores get in there. But when you add Negrete's in there, I believe their score will go up a little bit higher to seal the deal for North Carolina State.
You know, it's tough. You see some of the seniors crying over there on Ball State's team. You know, this was their final competition, and it's bittersweet, but they had a great showing tonight. You know, there was little mistakes here and there, but it happens.
Negrete's score is not in, but I can't imagine it being enough to knock North Carolina State out of it. It was a very good routine to wrap it up. And for North Carolina State, it looks like they will be moving on to session number two tomorrow in the second round. Oklahoma, Ohio State, and Arkansas will be waiting there. Iowa, Illinois, Kentucky, and Alabama are in session one. We await the final score, but it appears as though North Carolina State is going to go ahead and finish this thing out.
Yeah, and Ball State, they had a great showing on beam. Hats off to them for ending so well, despite some uncharacteristic things that happened, you know, on bars and then having two steps out of bounds on the floor. You know, that's exactly how you want to finish a meet, despite some things not going the way that you want early in the game. You never know what could happen.
So there is the final margin. You see North Carolina State 196.075 and Ball State 195.375. All of your final individual event winners are in as well. Emily Shepard wins the floor exercise, and Chloe Negrete takes home the beam title. Your all-around winner tonight is Emily Shepard of North Carolina State as well. The Wolfpack will be moving on. They will face Oklahoma, Ohio State, and Arkansas tomorrow night in round number two. For Natalie Brown, I'm Chad McKee, and we'll talk to you next time, everybody.